Hello.
Good morning.
You make me happy.
You make me excited. I knew I had to have a guy named Mark Reynolds, and one of the first things I did, Mark had three kids in college, you know, and I said, come work and you'll get paid, you know, he said, well, I'm not so sure. And so I said, okay, you go to Washington, come on to Washington with me. We went to the Results International Conference. And after the conference, we went up on the hill. We made some appointments to lobby on the climate. And one meeting after another, Mark had the aide or the member of Congress laughing before they could sit down. So when we got back to San Diego, I knew Mark wanted to do it. Like he was going to take a big risk on me, so I could shut up for a while. And then finally, we said, yeah, let's go ahead and do this thing. So I just love all the staff, and at this point, especially Mark, and well, there's a whole bunch of them, just terrific. Well, thank you for the stand that you have taken. A stand for all the earth and really for all of life. And thank you for leaving those comfort zones back home in Wisconsin or California and coming out to Washington to talk straight with your member of Congress in a polite and friendly and persistent, relentless way. So thank you so much for that. We've taken on a huge global task. Huge global task. It's the biggest problem that any of us could think of. We look around and say, what's the biggest thing we could, most difficult thing that we could take on, and here we are. And you know, it's just the right thing to do. You know, the first glimmer of this thing was, okay, yes, it may be impossible, but it's the right thing to do. And so let's do it. And then all kinds of things began to happen out of that. You know, first one was Mark and Amy and Steve popped up and Dan and Otto. Like, I can't mention all the staff, but they are just fabulous. You know, we never have looked at anybody's resume. They just show up and go to work and the face of this couldn't get better. Well, there's this idea that I came across years ago, which is from a guy named F. Scott Peck, the bigger, it is in solving problems, meeting and solving problems, that life has all its meaning. It is in meeting and solving the problems that life has all its meaning. And Peck went on to say that the greater the problem, the greater our growth. He was talking about our spiritual growth. So we're in for some growth here. And so I want to talk a little bit about this denial thing that's out there. It's starting to go away a little bit. And there is, in our communities, there is this indifference and denial and the hope that if we just ignore global warming long enough, it'll, you know, go away by itself, right? And it takes a certain kind of a courage to speak into that denial. And it's called moral courage. And I have a quote that I've kept around nearby for a couple of decades, maybe three. It's by Bobby Kennedy on moral courage, and I would like to read that to you. And you're going to see yourself in this quote. And it starts off with few, and that's you. Few are willing to brave the disapproval of their fellows, the censure of their colleagues, the wrath of their society. Moral courage is a rarer commodity than bravery in battle, a rarer commodity than bravery in battle, or great intelligence. And yet, it is the one essential, vital quality for those who seek to change the world that yields painfully to change. And I thank you for being people who are seeking to change a world that yields painfully to change. Now there's this thing about time. Before I woke up to global warming, I thought we had all the time in the world to solve life's problems. And now along comes this thing called global warming, and we realize that our time is not unlimited. We have got to act. We cannot postpone the solution, and the time for action is now. And here's the action. It's going to be a great big surprise to everybody. It's called carbon fee and dividend. Carbon fee and dividend. And it is working with our members of Congress in a friendly way. And polite way, and being relentless. I love that word. Relentless. So as I say, the time for action is now, and so the time for action is in this Congress, and it could be in the lame duck of this Congress, and we're going to pass legislation in this Congress or the lame duck of this Congress, or. If we don't pass it in this Congress, the lame duck of this Congress, we're going to pass it in the next Congress after the election. So with all this difficulty lack of promise of success, we have been given an opportunity, a great, great opportunity. It's like a historical opportunity that is in front of us. Really, it's at bottom, it's a victory of consciousness and responsibility over indifference, denial, and sleepwalking. And again, it comes with there's no choice about it. This particular problem, there is no choice about it. And humankind must succeed, and we will. And I've got another little quote here that, again, I've kept around for a long time. It's by the Spanish poet Fernando Garcia Lorca. And he is talking at this point essentially about this victory of consciousness and responsibility over apathy and indifference. And here is the quote. The day that we again have a stable climate on Earth, there will be the greatest spiritual explosion the world has ever known. Humanity cannot imagine the joy that will burst into the world on the day of that great revolution. And now this last thing. I believe that the universe is on the side of life. And I believe that we have cosmic companionship in this work. And so I invite you to have, as I have, a deep faith in the future. And so, I am all in. I'm all in. And every day, I see that you too are all in. And every day, I'm not kidding you, every day, I'm delighted to go to the office because I'm going to hear another knock your socks off story about something that one of you or a bunch of you have done together. You're just amazing people, and this is an extraordinary collection of people. And you light me up. And you light up the world. And you give life and aliveness and hope to all life. Thank you very, very, very